Hello everyone, in this video we will see the remote notification system using LabVIEW. Firstly, the authentication window will open, then through that we will open the LabVIEW application. Then we can acquire the data and also we can control the equipments. Then all these data will be sent to the web API in the JSON format. Then we can fetch data through any medium, either the web API or through mobile APIs. So let's begin. This is the authentication window. And the login is successful. Says that the thermocouple is initialized and also the motor has been initialized. So now we can run this thermocouple and we can acquire the temperature data. Yeah, we can see that the temperature data has been acquired. Now we can also control this motor through this, and yeah, we are seeing that the indicator as well as the thermocouple indicator is working fine. This is the thermocouple VI, this is the motor VI, and this is the main control panel. So what this project is doing is it's basically sending all the data to the web API so that we can get the notifications of these data wherever we are from any medium. Either it can be a web application or it can be a mobile application. So let's see how it works. So first we need to stop this. Yeah, it says that data logging has stopped and data uploading has stopped. Okay, then we see this. This is the sub VI which works behind the scenes to send the data to the web API. So here we can see the link is here, and all the data has been sent in the JSON format to this link. Let's see if it's working or not. So here we can see that it's working, and here lots of data has been collected. So we can match the data timestamp. Yeah, it says that it's 17:04, and yeah, we have just stopped the VI and it has sent so much data, RPM data and the temperature data. So let's see, here is a Python program which fetches the data, the relevant data, and we can see that it is fetching the right data, 93, which is the temperature data, and 1047, which is the speed of the motor. Now let's see if it is working in the running state or not. First we will reinitialize values to default. And now we run the VI. It says again that the motor has been initialized. Yeah, and we start the thermocouple and also the motor. Now we vary the speed of the motor. Note the speed of the motor, it's 683. Let's see. Yeah, actually it is getting the data 684, 84, and we can see that it's 683.7. it is rounding off the data, and we can also see that the temperature is variable and it's recording that. Now let's set the speed to a particular threshold. above 1400. Okay, let's see what happens to the notification system. It says hide speed because in the Python program I have mentioned that if the RPM speed is greater than 1155, it can be anything basically, it's just a random value. It has to show the high speed notification. So yeah, we are getting the high speed notification and also the temperature alert notification if the temperature is greater than 90. So yeah, we are getting that temperature greater than 90 data and also the speed data. So yeah, it is working fine. So as you have seen that we are fetching the data from a link given here. This particular set of instruction fetches the data multiple times from this API and gets us the relevant data with the notification. This can be done on any mobile app, on any web application, and we can get the data at any remote location. So this was my project. Hope you all liked it. Thank you.